What is a nanobody, presented by AbGene? Have you heard of a nanobody before? The name suggests it's a tiny antibody, but where does it come from? How does it compare to an IgG antibody? And what is it used for? We're going to help you understand. It all starts with an HCAB, or heavy chain antibody. Nanobodies are derived from this special type of antibody. HCABs are found in camels, llamas, alpacas, and other camelids. HCABs are similar to IgG antibodies, but they do not have light chain domains and also have one less heavy chain domain. This leaves the job of antigen recognition to the heavy chain variable domain of the HCAB. When a heavy chain variable domain is expressed by itself, it's called a nanobody. But wait, how do you go from a camelid to a nanobody? And how is a nanobody designed against an antigen of interest? Making a nanobody has similarities to how antibodies are made, but nanobody production does not require animal sacrifice. First, a camelid is immunized with an antigen of interest to induce antibody production. Next, blood is drawn from the animal and antibody-producing B cells are isolated. Then, the HCAB heavy chain domain genes of these B cells are cloned into plasmids. These plasmids, collectively called immune libraries, are used to express the camel's nanobodies in experiments which identify nanobodies that have high affinity for the antigen of interest. Lastly, random mutagenesis methods, in combination with more screening, can be used to increase affinity of the nanobodies for the target antigen. Once nanobody design is complete, the nanobody can be expressed in bacteria and purified with common molecular biology techniques. Then nanobodies can be used, much like antibodies, for Western blotting, immunofluorescence, ELISAs, and other techniques. So although nanobodies may be small, they are mighty.